Good day, and welcome to the inaugural broadcast of the Misadventures of Sinjin Smythe. This channel will chronicle one man's journey to partially fulfill a fairly common boyhood dream in a complete virtual reality. A little background. I grew up near an active military facility, Point Magoo Naval Air Station. I spent many hours watching and listening to F-14 Tomcats, F-18 Hornets, and F-4 Phantoms on their long finals for Runway 21. I got so good at recognizing the sounds of the engines that only a visiting British tornado ever challenged me.
Right. What did he say?
He said, as his edge, eh? He only chopped him down because he couldn't see the view no more. What's he mumbo?
Black Sheep Squadron, Top Gun, and The Right Stuff became my nightly thoughts just before I went to sleep.
I feel the need for speed.
Visualizing cockpits I'd seen in books, I would mentally go through my own process of starting, taxiing, takeoff, and operational control of tactical fighter aircraft.
Maggie Blue from Maggie Blue 1, go ahead.
Blue 2, okay, Skipper.
Blue 3, check.
Blue 4, receiving you R5S5, sir.
Blue 5, okay.
Blue 6, okay.
I especially loved mentally flying the chance-fought F4U Corsair and the Grumman F-14 Tomcat. Innocent childhood slumber usually assured I never made it to my first waypoint.
Go to sleep!
Being a poor student in school precluded me from any hope of flying these aircraft I had grown to love. No learning disability, socioeconomic disadvantage, or hard luck story to spin here. Just lazy. Put off till tomorrow what is annoying to do today.
Fat, drunk, and stupid is no way to go through life, son.
During my senior year in high school, I was approached by an Army recruiter who sold me on the idea of becoming a warrant officer and flying Apache gunships.
I'm not saying that the Army will be able to do for you what it did for me.
My dad tried to persuade me against the idea.
That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard in my life. No wonder you get D's and everything.
He said in Vietnam they were burying Army Hilo pilots every day and twice on Sunday.
What we've got here is failure to communicate.
Only way I'm getting in the air. Sign me up. Pass the smarts test.
I can handle things, I'm smart.
Pass the psych test.
Pettigate, Baker's man. Good morning, madam. I'm a psychiatrist.
Pass the physical fitness test.
Do you feel dizzy? Do you feel faint?
All I need was a clean physical and urine.
Just give me a chance.
Urine, clean, baby. Never was a partier and didn't have money for steroids.
Well, if there's anyone I can trust, it's a stranger at the gym holding a dirty needle.
Physical was awesome, right till the doc said, one more thing. And he pulled out a little black book written by Dr. Shinobu Ishihara. Little did I know that these pages of dotted circles would sever my future connection with flight. When page after page turned out to be nothing more than random dots for me, I noticed the doctor's expression suddenly change and become somber.
It'll be all right, Pop. You'll see. It's gonna be all right.
He told me that I was colorblind, and this would disqualify me from entering the program.
Yeah!
My recruiter assured me I could still join the army, just never get to do anything cool.
So if there's a problem, you must be that problem.
Although military aviation was apparently a no-go zone.
Say, is it all right if I join you? I just dropped in for a little drink to settle my nerves before I go to work.
What sort of work do you do?
I'm an airline pilot.
Surely, with the airlines begging for pilots, they'd take me.
I am serious, and don't call me Shirley.
Nope. Can't see color radar, so we have nothing for you.
So you get nothing. You lose. Good day, sir.
I went to work at the local airport and became a fuel service guy. I really wanted some way into the club. I thought, I'll get my private pilot's license, and at least I can fly my family all around the U.S. on vacations. Well, yes and no.
Whoa.
You can get a private pilot's license if you are colorblind, but it comes with some minor restrictions. Can't fly at night. Unable to see Bernoulli lights.
Just kidding.
Can't fly in bad weather. Wouldn't be able to be instrument rated.
Buckle yourself in.
Can't fly with passengers alone. Might hit bad weather.
I'll give you a winter prediction. It's gonna be cold, it's gonna be gray, and it's gonna last you for the rest of your life.
Cannot fly any cool airplanes for all the above reasons. So let me see if I understand this correctly. Even if I become a billionaire, Jay-Z, Beyonce money, and I could buy a squadron of any kind of warbird I want, past or present, I can never fly in one alone? Well, that's no fun. So I got my act together, went to college, and started a normal career.
You have no skills.
I told you I can totally be a lawyer.
I only tried flight sims on two occasions. In college, my roommate had a game called F-19 Stealth Fighter by Micropose. Played it for hours.
Let's play.
A few years after college, I tried getting into Microsoft's flight sim, but that never gave me the experience I was looking for, and I abandoned flight simulation altogether. The love of airplanes in general, and the flight bug specifically, has never left me. I occasionally go to air shows. At work, there are pictures of aircraft on the wall.
Okay, boys, let's get some pictures.
And I still run out to look at aircraft heading for Point Magoo. A couple months ago, when I was quite ill.
Good afternoon, sir, and how are we today?
Better.
Better?
Better get a bucket. I'm gonna throw up.
Gaston, a bucket for monsieur.
I came across DCS, Digital Combat Simulations, while looking around the internet. Big shout out to Cap and the rest of the guys at the Grim Reapers. Highly recommend you check them out. Much love to you guys. I was completely blown away by everything. I couldn't believe that you could put yourself into the world of combat aviation with a level of realism that was, at least for me at the time, mind-boggling. I wanted to jump right in, but after watching a couple different videos, I noticed that the level of aircraft knowledge alone made this a whole different ballgame compared to anything else I had ever experienced. I spent a couple weeks looking at the different aircraft trying to decide how to begin my adventure. Initially, I was drawn to the F-18 Hornet. I had seen the AB versions all the time over my house, and the modeling by Eagle Dynamics seemed beyond belief. I even downloaded the Navtops manual for the F-18. That's when inspiration struck.
I have a plan. You've got a plan.
What if I use DCS as a conduit to learn how to fly combat aircraft utilizing a traditional military training program?
Man, you are one pathetic loser. No.
When I looked throughout the internet, I was shocked how much detailed information on both the U.S. Air Force and the U.S. Navy's air training curriculum, including manuals, that are readily available. So here's the idea. I'm going to use an established DCS simulation curriculum to learn how to fly combat aircraft. And hopefully, you all will guide me in the choices of my career path. At each step, I'll let viewer input, unless the two of you who watch make really silly choices, to be a big factor on future training and career moves. Decisions like, should my next training aircraft be the BAE Systems T-1 Hawk, the Aero Vodochody L-39 Albatross, or the Northrop T-38 Talon? In no way do I want to insinuate that any of the actions portrayed have any equivocation to actual military training. With that heartfelt disclaimer of respect, let's have some fun.
Let's swing! You wanna swing?
But before we jump into our first day of training, we have to construct the real-world system that will allow our matrix to exist.
Can you fly that thing?
Not yet.
Next time on The Misadventures of Sinjin Smythe. Choices, choices, choices. How far down the rabbit hole does he really want to go?